Hello and welcome to this video on Parkinson's disease pathophysiology by Soton Brain Hub. In our Parkinson's disease anatomy video, we looked at 3D representations of the anatomy relevant to Parkinson's disease. In this video, we will look at the function of these structures and see what happens to them in Parkinson's disease, explaining some of the symptoms along the way. We will examine two important motor pathways in the brain, the direct and indirect pathways, and look at how these function in the healthy brain, and then look at what happens in Parkinson's disease. In our last video, we looked at the brain from an anterior view, like this, but to understand what Parkinson's disease does to the brain, we need a new model, not anatomically correct, but better for explaining pathophysiology. So here we have representations of the cortex, the striatum, the substantia nigra. This structure as a whole is the globus pallidus, but for the direct pathway we are only concerned with the medial globus pallidus. Then we have the ventroanterior or ventrolateral nucleus of the thalamus and the motor cortex. It's important to note that in our model this is all on the left hand side of the brain, and remember that the left side of the brain controls the motor function of the right side of the body. We will be talking a lot about the actions of these structures on one another, so it's key to understand that these actions can either be excitatory, which increase the activity of the structure being acted upon, or inhibitory, reducing its ability to function. In our video, green arrows will always be excitatory, think green for go, and the red arrows will always be inhibitory, think red for stop. Each arrow will be labeled with the neurotransmitter it represents. So let's start with the direct pathway. The striatum projects inhibitory GABA neurons to the medial globus pallidus, reducing its ability to act. And the action of the medial globus pallidus is to inhibit the VAVL nucleus of the thalamus from doing its job. What's the job of the VAVL nucleus of the thalamus? To send excitatory glutaminergic neurons to the motor cortex to stimulate it. And in turn, the motor cortex then sends projections via the corticospinal tract to the muscles. So from this, we can see that if we increase the activity of the striatum, it will inhibit the medial globus pallidus to a greater degree. This will reduce the inhibiting effect of the globus pallidus on the VAVL nucleus of the thalamus, allowing the thalamus to more strongly stimulate or excite the motor cortex. This ultimately allows the motor cortex to stimulate the muscles more by creating more motor activity. Now let's see what happens if we reduce the activity of the striatum in the direct pathway. The reduced activity of the striatum means that it doesn't inhibit or suppress the medial globus pallidus as much, allowing it to get on with its job of inhibiting the VAVL nucleus more. This inhibition of the VAVL nucleus causes less excitation of the motor cortex and ultimately reduced motor output to the muscles of the body. So now let's look at the effect of the cortex and the substantia nigra on the direct pathway. The cortex sends excitatory glutaminergic neurons to stimulate the striatum. The substantia nigra also stimulates the striatum in the direct pathway, but does so using dopaminergic neurons through the action of the neurotransmitter dopamine at D1 receptors. The effect of both is to increase the activity of the striatum, allowing it to enhance its inhibitory effect on the medial globus pallidus, thereby reducing the inhibitory effect of the medial globus pallidus on the VAVL nucleus of the thalamus. This allows the VAVL nucleus to increase its excitation of the motor cortex and leads to greater motor output to the muscles. But what happens in Parkinson's disease? In Parkinson's disease, there is a degeneration of these dopaminergic neurons which excite the striatum, so the substantia nigra is unable to stimulate the striatum to the extent that it used to. This causes the striatum to reduce its inhibition of the medial globus pallidus, allowing the medial globus pallidus to more strongly inhibit the VAVL nucleus of the thalamus. This in turn reduces the excitatory output from the VAVL nucleus to the cortex, and so reduces the motor output from the motor cortex to the muscles of the body. This causes hypokinetic symptoms, such as bradykinesia or slowness of movement, one of the main features of Parkinson's disease. we are now going to focus on the indirect pathway, and aside from all the other structures we have already seen, we now have the subthalamic nucleus added in. So this time, the striatum projects inhibitory neurons to the lateral globus pallidus. The lateral globus pallidus inhibits the action of the subthalamic nucleus, which is to excite or enhance the activity of the medial globus pallidus. The medial globus pallidus inhibits the VA-VL nucleus of the thalamus. And of course, as always, the VA-VL nucleus of the thalamus stimulates the motor cortex, and it's the motor cortex that provides motor output to the muscles of the body. So if we increase the activity of the striatum is able to inhibit the lateral globus pallidus to a greater extent. This reduces its activity, and so it inhibits the subthalamic nucleus less, allowing the subthalamic nucleus to stimulate the medial globus pallidus more. This increases the activity of the medial globus pallidus, making it inhibit the VA-VL nucleus to a greater extent, reducing the amount the VA-VL nucleus excites the motor cortex, and this ultimately leads to reduced motor output. The opposite occurs if we decrease the activity of the striatum in the indirect pathway. This is done by the action of dopamine from the substantia nigra acting at D2 receptors. The striatum therefore doesn't inhibit the lateral globus pallidus to the same extent, allowing it to increase its inhibition of the subthalamic nucleus. This reduces the extent to which the subthalamic nucleus can excite or stimulate the medial globus pallidus, reducing its inhibition of the VA-VL nucleus. This allows the VA-VL nucleus to stimulate the cortex to a greater extent and results in increased motor output to the muscles of the body. In Parkinson's disease, however, there is degeneration of the dopaminergic neurons of the substantia nigra, so there is reduced inhibition of the striatum, allowing it to increase its inhibition of the lateral globus pallidus. This causes the lateral globus pallidus to reduce its inhibition of the subthalamic nucleus, leading to the subthalamic nucleus to stimulate the medial globus pallidus to a greater extent. This stimulation of the medial globus pallidus allows it to inhibit the VA-VL nucleus more strongly, reducing its activation of the motor cortex, leading ultimately to less motor output from the cortex to the muscles of the body. This creates the hypokinetic symptoms we spoke of earlier, such as slower movements or bradykinesia. So there you have it. Thank you very much for watching. Leave us a comment below and let us know what you would like us to cover in our next video. Until then, remember to subscribe to Soton Brain Hub for more videos to help explain the mysteries of the brain.